All right, everyone, welcome back to episode 2 of Space Engineers Easy. I do apologize. I have a much better microphone now, so things should be a little bit easier to understand. Again, I apologize. So in this last episode, we landed with our little escape pod here. We built ourselves an assembler, basic refinery, some power. Now I do have a mod for a small grid wind turbines on here, as well as a couple other mods. Mostly just because I like small grid wind turbines, it makes life easier when you're dealing with this. I might take it off here in a minute, but we have to go over a few things first. Components, two motors. Two motors and 20 PLC. Oh, I need 4 displays. What do you know? What's going on with that one? That's like 5 seconds. Thrusters and build them back later. Looks like it's here. I do, however, need to build the hydrogen tank before I can build hydrogen thrusters. So, let's see here. Alright, that means we can grind these down without repercussions. There is repercussions, but none that I really care about right now. Don't plan on flying anytime soon. Near future.
Inventory full.
Oh, you know, inventory full. Drop it down. Yeah, actually, now that I think about it, do I really want to use this? Besides the battery. Of course I'm using the battery. Scrap this down until I get the battery survival kit. And then, I will see you guys back here. So the goal of this episode is to get ourselves little rover, so that we can, so we're getting ourselves a rover so we can drive around and find some battery response. We do know of our gold that's over there, but that's not very useful, especially considering our basic refinery over there cannot. Please. piston. So, sun's going down. I set these up for... Well, I set this round up for... I think it was 4 hours. I think it might be the original. Let's see here. Still haven't touched. How far do we have to go? Alright, 5.7 meter. And we are attached to the ground, so I can... distance. Now we want, should probably widen the wheel base a little bit. Yeah, widen the wheel base out. Wheels on him. Well, looks like I'm stuck. Probably should have thought this a little bit through a little bit more. But if I can do one thing. You know, what does it take to make a survival base on... Thank you. just start grinding the rest of this down. Now, I don't like the idea of grinding everything down to make one base, but for now, it's gonna have to do. So, base camp. Now, we need to add a few things to our little cheapo rover here. First things first will be antenna. Ourselves an ore detector on this side. Oh, well, good enough. Now, we have this as our parking brake, technically. I need for this. Need a steel tube. Alrighty. That's looking nice. Since it's getting dark. Actually, don't need bulletproof glass. There, so now we have ourselves a light. Scripts, driver's assist scripts, copy to editor. We'll just leave everything except forward speed limits is a max of 60, rear speed limit is a max of 30. It makes things easy, it's quite easier when you're doing it. I do need a remote control block though, and a gyro. So, G. They're all built up. There we go, I'm possibly one of the ugliest early rovers I've ever built, but it will work for the moment. Before we go anywhere, let's set your 250 antenna to 1k range. And I have the base camp already marked. Hi-ho, silver away. Now, let's go see if we can find ourselves some ores. Now, as I said, one of the smartest ways of doing this is going up and looking for patches. So, like over there is a patch. There's my gold ore. So, there is a patch. Looks like there might be a patch over there. Looks like that's probably our best bet. Can also do it this way. Oh, right, I forgot. So now we're starting to reach that patch. That's handy. Cobalt. Is that the only ore over here? More cobalt. I found a nice patch of cobalt. Oh, there we go. That's what I was looking for right there. Iron. Right here. Alright, so we have iron right here, and we are 2K from the base. So, what do I have on me? Not the best. But, let's see. Turn ourselves around and head back home. Now this is quite productive. We have ourselves a source of iron and a source of cobalt. Both very useful near the game. So, we're gonna head back. We're going to park up for the night, and that will be the end of this episode. I do apologize for that first episode being terrible in terms of you being able to hear me. So, I would like to apologize for that. I recently got a new microphone as of today, so hopefully things will be better from now on. I will try to be releasing at least one episode a week. However, work and other schedules may interfere with that. But look forward to episode 3 here, probably next weekend. So before I call it a night, we're going to do two things. Number one, we're going to see what it takes. Where's our Skallbjorn? 150 kilowatt power output. You know, I should be able to build this right now. So here's what. And there we go. What is. Figured that's another time. Well, we got ourselves a buggy build. Probably the ugliest thing I've ever built. We found ourselves some cobalt and some iron. And I would say all in all productive for a good day. So, I will see you later.